want to say, first off, an incredible job by Chris Bubich. He saved our pen and threw incredibly well. It's probably the best we've seen him. And had a great rhythm, best breaking ball we've seen from him. Changeup's always been there. But we needed that worse than he even knew. And did a great job of giving us a chance to not beat up the entire pen. And it was a one-inning game is what it looked like. It's just hard to recover. I don't know if I've ever seen one quite like that, to be honest. And it was just everything was hit hard. And that's obviously a tough one to recover from. But Chris did a great job in sort of Wade Davis coming in and eating up some pitches for us and giving us some outs. Besides that, getting a little something going. And here's the deal. We've got some teams in this division that we have yet to earn the respect of by playing the kind of baseball that we can play. And our guys need to understand that I don't even think we've seen us play the kind of baseball we can play yet. Doesn't make anything different except the fact that we got a lot of work to do. And nobody's going to give us anything in this league. And we got to keep working. We got to keep fighting. We got to keep believing in each other. And start to see some steps. We're starting to see some incremental things that are making us believe that that's sooner than later. But right now, it's a tough time. And it's not going to be the last one that we'll have. I've said from the beginning that this is a test on us. But the test is more in our minds than it is against whatever team that we're playing. And this team's ready for that challenge. And excited to watch them tomorrow. Go ahead. Go ahead, Lynn. You can call him out.
Okay. Hey, Mike, you mentioned, Chris. Was there anything in particular, I guess, first of all, do you have an idea how much you thought you could get out of him as far as length, or you just sort of playing it by ear when you brought him in?
He's built up to 80. He was good to go, and we asked, checking with him every inning, but certainly from the eye test, everything looked great, and he felt great. We had him built up high before he got here as a starter. So he had some in-betweens that would serve sort of as eye sessions that kept him active. And he looked better as he went.
And then the follow-up was just with Lynch. Was it just location, or what stood out to you in terms of that?
Yeah, I don't know, Lynn. I'm going to have to watch it again. But, you could almost tell anybody what pitch is coming and in what location and still not have those kind of results. This guy's got really good stuff, and he's got too good of stuff to get hit like that, and it's not going to happen. This was just one of those anomalies that I don't have a great explanation for. I think I'll probably tell you the same thing after I go rewatch the game. I imagine there was some mislocation, but still, you don't see that happen to guys with stuff like Daniel has. It's going to be one of those, we keep talking about, we're all learning. I don't think it's a surprise that a young pitcher is going to have some things that are going to have to learn on the fly. And it's going to be taking an inning like that. And we let that go, make some adjustments, be an honest evaluator of what we see, and then move forward. And can't wait to get him on the mound again.
I understand. I listened to the Royals broadcast, and I understand that Lynch was throwing his secondary pitches. Was that true, and why didn't he throw his fastball?
Well, he threw his fastball. He's trying to probably find something that was going to work. You start giving up hits, you're going to try whatever you can to get out of it. And you have to improvise sometimes. You can have the best game plan in the world. If you're making pitches and they're getting hit, you're going to have to make an adjustment. So he threw plenty of fastballs. Did he go to his off-speed pitches? Yeah, that's trying to figure out ways to survive.
And how good was it to finally break the scoreless streak? Your team is playing hard.
Yeah. I'd be lying to tell you if I didn't matter, even though we were down 8 runs. Yeah, I wanted to see a run come across the board just to, break that ice and let's go. We're not looking for one run or an 8-run game, but Just getting the one, because we had some opportunities that we weren't able to capitalize on. You know, credit good pitching, credit whatever you want. But we're a team that can score runs, and obviously we're going to need to. And it was good to at least put something on the board. It was good to have that little bit of a bump by Dice today. He did a nice job. Hit another ball hard that he made an out on, but had a lot of energy they brought into us. Energy really hasn't been our issue. These guys, as you said, Bill, they're playing hard. But there's another level that we need to take this thing to.